Thank you for asking some great questions. If you have some other questions that you would like to ask for future AskPiX episodes, please stay tuned till the end to learn how to do that. So without any further ado, let's get started. Aditya Rakshay asks this, is there any easy method to match the subject with the background? Aditya, my friend, I already have a video on just how to do that by using three major clicks combined with the eyedroppers. And the way you do that is by sampling the highlights, midtones, and the shadows of the background and simply applying that to the subject by using those three eyedroppers inside of the curves adjustment layer. You can check out this video and follow along. And also for your reference, I've written a guest article just about this on Scott Kelby's blog, so you can check that out. It's linked up in the description below. It also has some additional steps. Desi Animation, nice name, asks this, Bhai, which is your screen recorder? The screen recorder I use is called OBS, which stands for Open Broadcasting Software, and I've been using it since I began YouTube. And also, as the name suggests, it says open, which means it's absolutely free. Not only it does allow you to record the screen with lots of features available, but it also allows you to stream your videos with any video input. So for example, let's say you have a camera, you can have input from your camera to your computer and you can feed it into OBS as well and stream it. So any video input that your computer can get, you can just set it to OBS. It might be just your screen, it might be your camera, webcam, whatever there is. You can easily output that either in the form of a recording or live streaming. OBS works a lot like Photoshop's layer, so you can place your video feed or your screen's recording at the bottom. On top of it, you can place some rolling news or maybe your logo. So you can just composite any which way you want. You can do green screens with it. It's totally crazy and amazing. Now, if you're making presentations or recording tutorials like me, you can use a couple of other tools as well to highlight your cursor. The one that I recommend is called SwordSoft Mouse Track. It will be in the description below, and this one is for Windows. For Mac, you can use Presentation Assist. However, the thing is, for Windows, SwordSoft Mouse Track is a little outdated. There has been no great software in the recent history that has been as great as the SwordSoft Mouse Track, especially for high resolution monitors. So I'm going to show that to you. So you can just search in SwordSoft Mouse Track. It's actually free. It allows you to create a spotlight very nicely, so you can change the radius of the spotlight, opacity and color. You can have a border as well if you want to, something like this. I don't want to have a border. And you can have a show spotlight, you can have the shortcut. So whenever I press this shortcut, the spotlight will show up. It also allows you to show your keystrokes. So if I check this and whatever key I press, so I pressed the shift key, it shows me shift. If I press shift A, it's going to show me that. It's a wonderful tool. So check it out, SwordSoft Mouse Track. And for Mac, check out Presentation Assist. I'm not sure whether Presentation Assist is free or not. I think I remember paying about $2 or $3 for it. I do not remember, but SwordSoft Mouse Track is free. The next question comes from Catalina Cusimano. How do you change the color of wood, honey oak cabinets to white? Well, let's try that. So here we have a wood cabinet. First of all, let's target that exact color. So click on the adjustment layer icon and let's choose hue saturation. And as we showed in this tutorial, we'll target that color by using the hand tool and then click on that color on the wood. Now it's going to show up a color called red. So it comes in the red category. Take the hue and the saturation all the way to the right to make sure which areas are being selected. Now you can play with the range to just make sure all of the cabinet is selected. As you can see, a lot of other areas are red as well, have a little bit of red in them. So there might be other areas selected as well. No worries. We'll use the mask. So you can fine tune it as much as you want. I'm just going to make sure all of the cabinet is selected. Doesn't matter whether other things are selected or not. Just make sure all of the cabinet is selected. All right. Now, once the selection is final, once you make sure that everything is being affected, the cabinet, especially every area of the cabinet, just bring everything back to zero. And then all you have to do, increase the lightness to 100%. Now, we just need to apply it just to that cabinet. So what do? We create a mask out of it. Mask is already there. Just paint this area in white and other areas in black. White shows up, black hides. So I'm going to make a very rough selection for the sake of this tutorial. You can take all the time in the world to do it fast. So once you have the selection in place, you can take your time to select the legs and all of that. But anyway, so once you have the selection in place with the mask selected and the foreground color black, press Alt, Backspace or Option Delete. Now this is exactly the opposite of what we want. Press Ctrl or Command D. Now press Ctrl or Command I to invert it. It's at the moment it's gray. It's not looking white, it's not very exciting. So what do? We need to brighten it. And if you've been watching the channel for a while now, you already have guessed what I'm gonna do now. Curves. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Now whatever we do inside of the curves is applying all over the image. So what do we need to do? We need to clip it. So hold the Alt or Option and click on the line between these two to clip it, or you can press the shortcut Control Alt G, Command Option G. It clips as well. Now we can click a point in the middle and take it up. Make it more and more brighter. If you want to really fine tune it, it's already white, but if you really want to fine tune it, let's delete that. You can do that with the help of the hand as well. Have a look at the hand right there. Click on the hand. You want to make these brighter, these shadows. Just make them brighter to the point that you like. I like that. Now, as you can see, some areas are getting too bright. These areas. So you can just take it down to decrease the contrast and still make it brighter. Something like that. Now, you want to have a little bit contrast. If you want, you can just create a point on the left hand side. Take it down if you want a little contrast. And there you go. That's how you can turn it absolutely white. Now, let me minimize that. And here is the before. Here is the after. It's white, as easy as that. Now, on top of this, if you think the contrast is too much, you can always create one more curves adjustment layer. Clip this as well by pressing Ctrl Alt G, Command Option G, and then decrease the highlights, increase the shadows. This is just decreasing the contrast to make it even more convincing. There you go. Here's the before, here's the after. White cabinet. Let's move on to the next question. Michael Van Willingen asks this. How to get rid of chromatic aberration that remains even after you have checked the box in Camera Raw? Michael, my friend, I always prefer Lightroom for removing chromatic aberration because of just one thing. That is the easy accessibility to the eyedropper. You can always activate the eyedropper in Camera Raw by holding the Control or Command, but in my opinion, Lightroom does a better job. So let me show you how I do it in Lightroom. Have a look at this photo. This is the St. Louis Arch. So if I zoom in, there's a little bit of chromatic aberration, right? So I can go to Lens Correction right here in the Develop module. We have the Lens Correction. Now inside the Lens Correction, we can go to Profile. And inside of that, we can check Remove Chromatic Aberration. And as soon as I check that, have a look, most of it is gone. But there is still a little bit left. Now, some images are going to have a little too extra chromatic aberration even after you check this. So your question is how to remove the chromatic aberration even if it is not going when you check it. So when I checked it, there's still a little. So you need to go to Manual. And inside of that, have a look at this eyedropper. So click on this eyedropper and you need to just take a sample of the chromatic aberration. So right here, I think it's the correct sample. No, it's not. See, it became worse. So let's go back and let's try that again. Maybe in this area. Did not work. Maybe in that area. And it worked. See, I clicked it. All of it is now gone. And you can just click back in here to bring the eyedropper back to its space and have a look. These adjustments are automatically done according to the area that I clicked in. And it's totally gone. There is just no chromatic aberration. And that's how you remove it very easily in Lightroom. And that's all for today. Thank you so very much again for asking some great questions. You know your support means really a lot to me. If you have an interesting question that you would like for me to answer, please let me know. I would love to do that. And you can ask questions by following me on Twitter @PiXimperfect and then asking your question using the hashtag AskPiX. That's it. That's all, folks. I hope this video helped you, and this video was made possible by these amazing people who support PiXimperfect on Patreon. And if you're a Patreon member, you have access to exclusive PiXimperfect Patreon family Facebook group where you can ask any questions you want, and all of your questions will definitely be answered. You can also get in touch with me personally if you are a Patreon member. Do check it out and please consider supporting PiXimperfect. And if you just go ahead and check it out, you'll get 3 free actions. So, thank you so much again. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.